420, DD.
Happy 420.
Happy 420.
Happy
420. This is God Morning America, and we are just simply having a terrible time. So what I'm really here to talk to you today about is... Okay, everybody. Get up. It's time to solve some puzzles.
This red light is threatening to stay red.
Wow.
Okay. I think that I should just start. I'm just going to do it because this is going to be really important for me to do. Okay. I am recording this for posterity. This is a scientific endeavor. The drug in question itself is a Schedule 1 substance, as determined by the Drug Enforcement Agency of America Administratives. To unlock the secrets of cannabinoid exploration, this is an act of noble sacrifice which I will undertake in order for scientific progress to be made for the aged and the ailing and the neurodivergent and those who need a little bit more extra help. Okay. Here goes nothing. It would seem as though I'm beginning to feel a little bit of the effects. My brain, my sulci, and my dry rye seem to be completely permeated and satiated by the substance itself, the Schedule 1 substance. We have about half an hour to a full hour until the peak concentration takes place. So let's make some more observations. My basal ganglia seem to be ignoring commands from my prefrontal cortex, but luckily it seems as if my PFC has fully suppressed the activation of my amygdala. This is gonna be okay, this is good for us. Maybe just a little bit more. Maybe just for science I should try and have a little bit more. Okay. What was that? I think I'm starting to get it. Hello? what? Hey? I don't need these anymore. You know what, science? Yeah, this is she. Whoa. I think we all just need to chill. What is this connected to? I think we need to TakeItEasy.com. Huh? Live and let live. That's my hypothesis. Okay, I think I'm actually stoned.
Terrible time. Terrible. Okay.
Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of God Morning America here at Austin Public Access Studios. We are very excited to have four lovely guests on our game show this evening. Would you like to introduce yourselves, starting over with the person who's texting and putting their phone away?
Well, wait a minute now. I got no briefing about this at all.
Well, and here you are, nonetheless, you came.
My name is David Fox.
Welcome, David. Have you selected a buzzer for this game show? Okay, so you'll be buzzing in by picking up whatever that old-fashioned device is that I've never seen before.
Yes.
Okay.
I think it's a dog bone. It's a big dog bone.
You could chew on it. Who else do we have here?
Hello, I'm Aurielle Jenkins, and I am excited to be here.
And how will you be buzzing in?
I think I'm going to buzz in via the reflectors, the light reflectors, because my eyes are sensitive.
I can see it. We got a lot of lights here in the studio, so maybe you'll actually be able to see me with those on. What else do we have here?
I am Mia, and I have subjected myself to whatever fantastic things happened today. I'm happy to be here, and I have selected this herbal grinding device to be my buzzer. So.
Awesome.
I'll do that. There's definitely not anything in here that would be contraband in any way, though.
Great. We're big fans of herbal tea here at God Morning America. And who else do we have?
I'm Tarek. I'm 16 and a half. I'm from San Diego, Costa Mesa.
Welcome. How are you going to be buzzing in?
Ending it for my dude.
All right. Hopefully you won't be buzzing in too much. Okay, I'm going to remember two of those names, and with that being said, let's get started. So, in honor of 420, this is one of our most stonedly conceived games. We won't get super stoned for round one, which is to say nothing about round two, but this is based on my absolute favorite news source in the entire world, the New York Post, and they're especially great at writing headlines, and that's what I really wanted to showcase is the great headline writing over at the New York Post with this game show. Also, I've been inspired by the recent popularity of games like Wordle, Hurdle, Spottle, Bandle. Have you heard of these?
Quartle.
Quartle? What's Quartle?
It's four different Wordles at once.
It's four. That's too much.
It's really
for me.
Cool. No, it's great.
You do that?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm probably not going to be doing that one anytime soon. But I do enjoy Wordle and these other games that kind of have you guess what's going on slowly with little bits of a trickling stream of small amounts of information. So for this, what we're gonna do is I really want you to try to guess what the New York Post headline is about based on a slow trickle of words. So I'm gonna show you three incomplete slides so you get to see a little bit of the headline, and then we'll see how close you are with the real slide. Does that make sense? Awesome. So
yes.
This is, we're calling this one New York Postal. So please, in unison, let's all say, let's go New York Postal together. Ready? Okay. Our first clue. What could this New York Post headline possibly be about? We see only one word, and that word is seafood. So not too much to go on, just like Wordle. Anyone want to take a guess? What could this post be about when we just see the word seafood?
I'm gonna buzz in.
Okay, what was your name?
Aurielle. Shrimp.
Okay, I've seen the headline, and it's not about shrimp, but there's very little to go on. So please, can we see the next slide? Okay, seafood date night. Getting a little more information here. What could this be about? Seafood, okay. Chattathy or whatever.
Eating sushi off a lady.
Okay, I think we're actually getting a little bit closer. Eating seafood off a lady. That's something you do on a first date. You eat seafood off a lady together with your date. But that's not correct.
I don't know about that.
It's getting closer though. Can we see another word, please? All right, we're in Milwaukee now. Milwaukee seafood date night. Okay, mm-hmm. Mia.
Red Lobster.
We're getting actually a little further off. It's not about Red Lobster, although I'm glad you mentioned that
really
because they
place.
Are an official sponsor of God Morning America. We love their Cheddar Bay biscuits. Unfortunately, no one actually got the correct what this is about. Can we please see the next slide and see what this is actually about? It's actually Milwaukee sicko, 33, allegedly dismembered teen college student, 19, after seafood date night. And then sick son of a bitch, they call him.
Oh, no.
Let's go New York Postal.
Thank you. That is 10 points. So after the first round, Chadmantha, or whatever, has 10 points, and unfortunately everyone else is sitting at, let's just say like 25. Okay, everyone else is winning. All right, let's go on to the next round. We're going to see you one word. Okay, singer. What could we be talking about here? Singer.
Sewing machines.
That is a negative 100 point deduction.
We're talking about Beyonce.
We are not talking about Beyonce, though. Again, we're...
Why not, though?
We're in the right... Well, she's a singer, so, I mean, in the sense that...
Beyonce Knowles.
Closer, but
that's
not particularly close. Okay, Mia.
What is Beyonce Knowles?
It's not what is Beyonce Knowles. Let's see the next slide, please. Let's get another word. Okay, fiance. Singer.
What does her fiance know?
You're so close.
We're very close.
You're so close.
You know, anytime you want to buzz in. Okay.
Fiance Knowles.
Fiance.
Oh!
I was going to say that.
That is
and
still
you
not any closer. I'm thinking we might try guessing away from Beyonce on this one. But again, I'm not here trying to tell you how to do your job. Let's see another word.
Taylor Swift's quarterback fiance.
It's not Kelsey. This is Kelsey Grammer.
Kelsey Grammer.
Let's see the next word, please.
Wait,
okay, estrogen. Now it's getting in a really strange place. Yes, Mia.
Transgender female singing telegram person is murdered over estrogen. Over estrogen.
Okay, we are we're rapidly getting further away from what this is about. Can we actually see what the full headline is? It's actually hardcore singer accused of dosing bandmate with estrogen in an attempt to steal his fiance.
Whoa!
And
did he get her?
Yeah, absolutely.
I didn't read the article. I usually can't really quite read the articles because of how many ads they have that pop up when I try to read the articles. And
a lot.
I'll bet you they're anticlimactic.
No.
The stories.
They're rarely, I mean, what I can read of them are usually pretty bombastic in nature. All right, we have a couple more rounds here. Let's see another word. Okay, Mexican. Where are we going this time? Chad, Mantha, too.
My name's Oriel.
Oriel, there we go.
And... we're obviously talking about food.
We could be talking about food. It's true that in Mexico, like several other countries, there's lots and lots of food. Let's try another word, though. Oh, that is hard to... that one is hard to read because of a shadow.
Erase.
I like that.
It is... I happen to remember the word is eclipse.
Oh!
Which is recently in the news.
It's being
for...
It didn't go over
it was.
Mexico.
It was a total... camera clip.
Canada is passing in front. Oh, wow. It is true. That was a real... We actually did have a real eclipse. Good observation. That'll earn you half of a point. Let's see the next word.
I'll take it.
Okay, coverage. All right. Mexican eclipse coverage. What's happening here? Yes.
Taco Bell introduces new Mountain Dew eclipse Seafull coverage if you subscribe to the ads on New York Post.
Well, that is true. Taco Bell
answer.
Does offer whatever
answer.
You just said if you subscribe to New York Post.
Or,
it also offers that same thing if you watch God Morning America. So our first 100 viewers of this program will receive whatever you just said from Taco Bell for completely free.
It only hurts.
Unfortunately, that is not what this headline is about. Can we see the full headline, please? It's actually Mexican TV outlet accidentally airs man's testicles during
fantastic.
Solar eclipse coverage.
Mm. That was great.
It can happen to anyone.
Get the chance to see that. It was really great.
Yeah, I mean,
they're beautiful.
Everybody makes mistakes.
I've
I mean, I'm sure
like
on eclipse, people make more mistakes.
Wait, were the testicles eclipsing?
Yes. They had twisted around one another, and the left testicle was passing the right testicle.
Oh, my God.
Distortion. Testicular torsion.
Oof.
Let's see the next clues, please. Okay, kilt. Could we be in Scotland? Have we traveled from Mexico to Scotland, perhaps?
Not past tense of murder.
I don't want to influence you. Not a bad guess. It could very well be that.
It's Old English, right?
Kilt.
Any guesses?
No guesses.
I'm not fucking answering this one.
That's okay. Well, you're in the lead anyway.
Oh, wow.
Yes. Ursula.
Ursula, that's
it's,
not...
It's Oriel.
Oriel.
Like Oriel, but with an L.
Okay, like Oriel Pink. I'll remember that. I'll just think
ooh.
Pink.
Oh.
And the or
ouch.
L'Oreal. Okay.
L'Oreal.
L'Oreal.
It's closer, yeah.
What have you got for us? Kilt.
Scotland, because that makes the most sense to me.
Yeah. Okay, the rest of the clip is not just the word Scotland, but good guess. What else could we? What else could this be about?
Yeah. Ewan McGregor.
Ewan McGregor. I forget what he's in, but I know there's some real.
Train Spotting.
That's
Obi Wan.
It's a good one. He's Obi Wan.
In
right.
The new shit.
Okay, I thought he looked
in the half new shit.
Keep it
not
fresh.
The newest shit.
He hasn't worn a kilt in that, does he?
Yeah.
He possibly does.
It's arguable.
Yeah, he wears
but
a dress in it for sure.
I remember seeing Obi-Wan when I was like 6 years old in theaters and just leaning over to my mom and saying, "Is that the guy from Trainspotting, Mommy?" And she said, "Yes, good eye, son." Let's see the next word. Okay, antiques, kilts, antiques. What could this one be about?
Oh, man. So many options. I'm gonna guess.
Please.
A man wearing a kilt broke into an antique store to make restorations that he was gonna later on sell sky high at a record profit.
All right, I'm gonna break protocol here. Hopefully I won't get taken off the airwaves for breaking protocol here, but that was actually close enough that let's skip ahead too and see what this one's about. Kilt antique shopper.
Oh,
kilt wearing shopper seen stuffing antiques up his butt and then placing them back
that
on
the shelf. That is restoration.
You just
high.
Guessed that?
I did.
That
you
bad
know,
is very much
when you
like.
You say that's restoration hard.
I think I earned.
I think you should. You're
point.
In first place now.
He seems nice.
I think so. That's going to be 200 and 150 points.
Hey, that's my cousin.
Is it really? Well, this is a family program, so we do like to highlight whenever we have family members showcase on this show. I actually can't remember if there's another one. Can we please take a... Okay, we have one more. And this, now I do remember. I like this one because this, if you are fans of the New York Post, which I really am, it's not a joke. I really do love the New York Post. This features one of their absolute favorite topics. So if you read a lot of New York Post, a clue on this one is that this will be about one of the New York Post's absolute favorite topics. But the word we have right now is flying. What could this be about?
Flying Burrito Brothers, Spirit of the Rodeo.
Okay, it is not Flying Burrito. Is that a band or something? I forget what that is. That's a real thing, right?
Sure.
Burrito
okay.
Brothers.
All right, well,
this is an
educational program, so we've learned a little bit of something about that band. Let's see another word. Okay, class, flying.
Donald Boxing. Trump's flying first class.
Donald Trump probably is not flying first class as much these days, but, you know, probably sometimes.
But isn't Donald Trump one of their favorite subjects?
That's true. Okay, you're right. So I'll give you 140 million points for that one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Just like Donald Trump.
I should warn you, this is scored like golf, though, so you don't want to score
yeah,
too
David,
high.
David, you're on the next lead
I didn't
now.
Get more points.
Well, like I said, this is it's golf rules, so highest score loses.
Oh.
Well, should I just go ahead and
closest
lead
to
then?
Par.
I hope not.
Or can I bet it all at the end?
We don't, I
and
mean,
catch up with everybody.
It would be our first walk-off on this show.
Well, you might want to go for
so.
It.
History. but I don't want to miss the smoke out.
It stinks like drugs.
That's true. You don't want to miss the drugs, which is the reason most guests don't walk out of talk shows
and the
or game shows. They don't want to miss out on the drugs at the end. What's our next word here? Okay, airplane. You know, not the biggest new clue, you know. Please.
Donald Trump flying second class in an airplane.
Oh!
Okay.
Boom!
Now.
You know what? We can, we'll make a little political joke. Let's call that one close and see what the real clip is. Flying roach class. Cockroach is spotted running amok on airplane in horrifying video.
Oh,
how much are those tickets?
Oh, no.
This is, the New York Post absolutely loves cockroaches.
That's on Spirit.
We really appreciate you joining us for another game show here on God Morning America at Austin Public Access Studios. We have another round coming up, and this one's going to be a fun one, so please don't miss it. Stick around. Woo. Thanks, y'all.
Thank you.
That's one. Wait, we come back. That's one. Right.
Is the second round also New York Post headline?
Yeah, the second one. No, it's different. It's New York Post. It's New York Post.
God Morning America is about the news, right? What's happening in the news? Iran, drones and missiles. Israel, the United States shooting drones and missiles. Child was injured. And Iran, UN, Syria killed, shot down. That's really close. And I don't want you to get discouraged or like stop smoking weed because of this, but I think that there is a monster, you know? I think that God Morning America is gonna get to the bottom of that today.
Space Kush.
Welcome back.
Hey, it's been a long time.
It's been a while since we did rubbish on the set.
I know, I can't wait.
I'm really excited to try and break this world record with you.
Me too. What do we got in store?
Well, in reverence of the holiday, I thought it would be cool if we tried to make a, you know, like a themed dip.
All right. I love a dip.
Yeah,
I love
so
a chip.
We're going to try and do a 420 layer dip.
Wow.
Yeah.
Is that, do you think that's the record? Have you checked?
It feels like a record.
It feels like it.
Yeah.
We'll have to do some research later.
Well, yeah, we probably won't fact check that part.
Right.
We just want to, you know, be, have the record ourselves.
Okay. Well, I guess integrity on God Morning America is a thing of the past.
Right. A salty kiss on the way to
come on your lip, buddy. A greasy crisp. Did you dice this yourself?
Yes, this was diced by me. And you're welcome to enjoy some if you'd like.
I'd love to.
Okay, so layer one, in the corner. Or maybe it's in the corner, layer one. Bing!
In the corner?
Oh yeah, I'm gonna put it up on the screen.
All right, we'll have to edit this part out.
I intend to edit out a lot of it. We have some shredded cabbage.
Okay, we're off to a strong start, cabbage and pineapple.
Yummy stuff, right?
It's a popular combination in Italy, if I'm not mistaken.
Yamba. Do you think they're putting pesto on theirs?
I hope not.
I heard that they do stuff like that.
You know, you can never put it past those crazy Italians.
They love flavor.
Right. You know who else they loved? Hitler.
Mussolini.
Jinx. And what was Hitler's birthday again?
April 20.
That's right.
Wow, what a connection. I've got some sliced jalapenos here. Ooh. Don't eat these, Dee Dee.
Oh my god, there's a dog here.
Oh yeah, she's here to make sure.
When did you get here?
She's actually sent by the Ripley's Believe It or Not, or Guinness Book of World.
Oh, you're a Guinness girl.
Records. Yeah, she's here to fact check our process. Some shredded pork butt. Our dip is getting more and more delicious. And what is that, layer 69? So I thought we could add some green beans in a layer.
Okay.
Here you go, Dee Dee. You can have a bean, honey. Can't she?
I think so. I haven't.
Oh, all this dip stuff, and I brought no napkins. Here, do you need to wipe your butt?
No. I don't like to be too clean. It's a cooking show. We don't want to get too hygienic or anything.
Yeah, what are we fucking surgeons?
No. No, we're not.
Would you like to add cucumbers to this dish?
I would.
Okay, perfect. I've got some sliced cucumbers here.
You didn't mean like, would you like you to add cucumbers?
Would you like me to like you to like me to add cucumbers?
Yes, please.
You want to eat some?
Okay. My hand's covered in dogs and ass.
So let's add a layer of chili flakes.
All right.
Sound good?
Yeah, I think I can kind of see where this is going now. You're going for
this
kind of like...
This is a Dee Dee deterrent.
Right. You're going for kind of like Julia Child meets Martha Stewart.
Should we do a layer of vinegar or is it too soon?
I do love vinegar.
Let's see if I can drizzle this nice.
Actually, it's too soon.
Let's add a smooshy layer of bean. These are lima bean.
I know Dee Dee love bean.
I cook them with some bay leaf and a sliced onion.
Oh wow, so that's, this is three extra layers.
That's three layers
that's
right
three
there.
Three layers, what
I
are we at
I think
we're
up
now?
To like 102.
Okay, we just have 102 more to go and we'll be to 420.
So I think we should add a layer of feta. Ooh, this'll be good. Feta cheese. Do you like sheep's milk cheese?
I love sheep's milk cheese. So does Dee Dee.
This is a really good one if you want to munch.
Please. That's what we're here for. Getting our hands dirty.
I love the feta brine too.
This is going to be a real sanitary salad.
Here, let's add a layer of diced pepper. These are pretty.
Are these hot peppers or are those of the bell variety?
One jalapeno and then the other ones are just those tiny sweet ones.
Oh, I love the tiny sweet ones.
Again.
We're kicking it up another notch here. Dee Dee has a question.
Hi, Dee Dee.
And that question is, can she wear your hat?
That would be so adorable.
But what if my hair goes all into the dish?
Well, I don't think it'd be the only hair. I think there's a hair party going on
here
in
there. Here we go. Goodbye, Dee Dee. She's not got enough noggin.
Oh. Chef Dee Dee, do you have any ideas for layers?
What would you like to add? Oh, really? You want to add some bacon? She wants to add the bacon.
He likes bacon. This is decadent. This is just like the ancient Greeks when they used to feed them grapes while they reclined.
Would you like some pickled jalapenos in there?
Absolutely.
I think that'll offset the bacon.
Oh, that's true. You have to cut the fattiness.
Yeah, the richness. The richness is really what takes over, no?
Absolutely. This dip is looking rich.
Yeah, I need more gloopy factor.
I think that term comes from because this is what the rich eat.
Let's add some Hawaiian black sea salt.
Wow.
Now it's really rich.
And is that black due to volcanic activity?
Yeah, it's got rock shit in it.
Oh, wow.
Can you imagine?
I can't.
Look at this wacky dip.
We will need a...
It's obscene, no? Ooh, let's do a layer of cotija. That sounds good.
It's a two cheese dip now.
Should we do a layer of lime juice?
I thought you were just going to put the whole lime in.
Would you like that?
You know, probably not to eat, but...
Visually stunning.
Visually, it could look good.
A layer of lime. I think we're at $3.98. Another layer of pit pez.
And is the goal to try to get a little bit of each item in every single bite?
Yes. Okay. So this is another smoochie factor, or however I called it before.
That's right. It's a, could we call it a binder, perhaps?
A binder.
A textural binder.
Oh, look at these black binks. Wow. This is going to be the best, one of the best layers of the dip. Maybe like two more?
Just two more beans, please.
Okay. So I've got diced onion, but I also have sliced onion. Which would you prefer?
Well, you know, we can't go wrong with both, can we?
True. And we'll get more layers.
That's right. Although I don't know if the people, the good people over at Guinness will count those as separate layers.
What are you saying? Could we do a layer of garlic powder?
A whole layer?
Yeah.
Like a desert layer?
Like a nice sneeze.
I think in geology this would be called silt.
Add the silt. This is going to be a binder for your dip and hold all the ingredients in place.
I see, but the black beans, those were not a binder.
A layer of tomatoes.
Are these dressed? They glisten as if dressed.
That's their personal sweat.
Uh-oh. They've been working out?
These tomatoes have been working out. Would you like some olives in your dip?
I would.
These are Kalamata olives.
They've very well been made in Taiwan.
We've been to Taiwan. I'm going to add some strawberries because I think it's quite cheeky when you use strawberries the way you would use a tomato. It's looking pretty good to me.
And yet, I think we're going to keep going.
We'll do a layer of chipotle.
Okay.
Maybe some gold coins.
Are we going to remove the wrappers?
I think it visually adds to the dish.
It's true. We could also use them as the chips.
Let's do a little bit of vinegar. This is a cure-all panacea. Anything that's wrong with you, just have a bit of this and it'll get flushed right out. Right. Isn't that right?
Absolutely. I think we could say the same for this dish, that if you're not feeling well, that this dish we're assembling right now is just the thing for you when you're not feeling too well.
I do want to add some S&P TT. And then let's add a little bit of sal. Cream gravy.
Okay. What does this saying go? In it for a minute, in it.
We are in it for the 420 limit.
I think a lot of chefs are afraid to cross into the territory of not being able to eat part of the ingredients.
Yeah, they say.
Because they're made out of tinfoil.
You know,
tin
they
foil.
Say you shouldn't put inedible stuff on your plate.
It could be easily mistaken for a dessert at this point with the festive gold coins.
Where is it? Curly parsley.
Perfect. It's good to get a little bit of freshness.
I like a bit of roughage. Oh!
We have some MSG.
This is, I think, gonna save it.
Let's add a sprinkle of MSG. That'll give us a nice sort of chicken soup sort of feel. Just a bit of blue cheese in this dip is really gonna set it off.
I'm excited. Blue cheese is one of my favorite cheeses and blue foods. And did you get scoops by any chance?
Yeah!
Perfect.
Non-denominational scoops.
Excellent. Oh,
just
agree.
On top to sort of set it off.
Right. I think in England, crisps are referred to as dip layers. So this is perfect.
And count it up here on the corner. 419 layers. We need one more layer. Come on, everybody. Can we do it? Can we do it?
Bees?
Bees. We could put bees in it. Oh, they're stinging me. Come on. Okay, we'll just add some bees in here. They're colorful bees. We did it! Wee 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 wee
cheers.
Cheers,
everyone.
In this scoop, I have got.
You gotta get everything. You gotta get a little bit of everything.
I'm trying to go deep. My scoopy's breaking. I see feta, onion, tomato, olive, pepper, parsley. Where's all the goofy stuff?
There's a layer of, there's an obstructive layer of cabbage. It's kind of a barrier to several of the flavors.
Oh, man.
All right.
Cheers.
Cheers. Thanks again.
Yeah,
thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you for helping me break this record. The vinegar is so good. Wow.
I didn't have an end game when I put that coin in my mouth. All right.
So glad we could break the record, Nikki.
Mm-hmm.
If you want the recipe for this, you should go to hell.
I'll put it.
Apologize for letters I wrote when I was angry. I only meant the first few lines. I figured things got better and it was better to let the sleeping dogs lie. But you've got a loving heart and you've got a careful mind. Of nerve to run through mine. They were never meant to be found, like I was never meant to be found. They were something I saved. I don't think I'm meant to be saved. I don't think I'm meant to be saved. I don't think I'm meant to be safe. I don't think I'm meant to be safe. I don't think I'm meant to be safe. I apologize for thoughts I had when I was hurting. I only meant the last few lines. And when the medicine started working again, everything seemed fine. You've got a curious heart and you've got a stubborn mind. And you've got a lot of nerve for fixing a fixed mind. They were never meant to be found. The guy was never meant to be found. Something I say, I don't think I'm meant to be safe. 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 I don't think I'm meant to be safe.
wonder if you're like too in between things to like be truly beautiful. You know, like what is the ideal like beauty? You know, like the sharpness of a knife.
100 points for everybody.